Alright. Best scope ever. Boom, zoom. Oh, it has a diskette. Every scope should have a diskette.
Yeah.
And every scope should have a game like this. So you turn it and you go save. Then you go save. Then you go new file. And you type rock underscore on this button, yes. So you do R-O-C-K.
Rock on.
Okay.
Okay.
And then you get creating bitmaps. And there you go. You have a fully functional scope. That can now be used for real engineering.
Oh, lose points if you stop shooting. So just by existing, you're losing points.
Ah, you've got to do something. You want to launch it? Launch it. Start. There you go.
All right. Oh, you're negative 200 already.
The quality is so good. I thought it was vector graphic, but I see it's raster graphics, but really well done.
Well, they say generating bitmaps, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems like good resolution.
I zoom on it and maintain focus. On focusing.
That's not fair.
That was an excellent demonstration. Thanks, Mike. So don't you like the scope?
Yeah, this is great.
Isn't it a great scope? I think so too.
Alright, I need to move in this level. Where's the UFO? There he is. Oh, crap.
Can you zap the UFO?
Yeah, you get points if you hit the UFO. There
he
is. UFO shot.
Got him.
Oh, great. Maybe we should leave you the scope for a week or two.
Man.
It's a good thing Apollo didn't have to deal with things like that.
Right?
Oh, nice.
Get him.
And you know what? It's just a plain good scope too. There was a time where an HP made uninspiring digital scope, the first generation of those. They were in very large cases, they were unresponsive, the screen was kind of dim and low resolution, but not this one. For once, it comes up right away. Tell that to my modern Keysight scope. And then it is super responsive. Trace is very lively. The interface is super well designed. Actually, it works well. It's actually the same as in the new scope, but they screwed it up in the new scope. So here, for example, coupling DC, I do AC, and it tells me. The new scope doesn't tell me that. It has lost its informative display. Setting the math is a breeze. Math. Okay, here we go. We have the derivative, and if I want to move it around, where is it? Math. I go settings, and I go offset, and broom. I would have to dig to 20 menus to do that in the new scope. Same, the trigger, there are buttons for the different triggers. What a concept. So, you know, in the new one, you have to dig through menus. Here, they're all here. One, two. The worst is the new Keysight scope where you can't even access the one or two menu without going to a sub menu. And then the format is very small, it's very light. I tell you, best scope ever. And here's the new one for comparison. Same speed, 100 megahertz, two channels. Da 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 da. Jump. Jojo, Jojo, Jojo. There we go. It woke up, and you notice it's it makes way more noise than the old one. And then my measurements are in here, man. Okay, fine, it's in color, but I can't read anything. It's all super cluttered. It's over here. And then horror of horrors, to change the trigger from channel 1 to channel 2, I have to trigger. And where is it? It's not in there. So you would think that it is a trigger channel somewhere? No, it's in trigger type. And then when you are in trigger type, you go to source. Finally, you find it. Okay, and I can change it to 1, and then it doesn't want to go away. You have to press another button. There you go. Finally, it goes away. Anyhow, no, of course, I mean, it has progressed. The hardware, no 2 gigabit per second sampling rate. But man, the software, it's gone backwards by a huge amount. Well, this guy, I think Mr. Good Firmware Designer, unfortunately, has retired. But man, he once did a very good job. Kudos to you, Mr. Firmware Designer.